I started this work because in our lab where I'm working is a terrain research lab. So we have a lot of expertise to work in the optical data, microwave data to give the digital elevation model and solve motion model to our user. So for the last 1.5 years we are thinking that how we can, because there is no supply which is giving the thermal imagery. So how you can able to use the thermal imagery which can give some value added product for our user. Because when we are working, because it's a lab for the defense application, so we are trying to give that one. And then when we are working for an area, it will be always better to work for a Himalayan terrain, which is always a complex. So that is why the work has been generated, and then we have thought of to calculate the land surface temperature. And the reason behind to work for the Landsat data, we know that model data is giving you coarser results. But when you see the local phenomena, because the dynamics of the Himalayan is so so dynamic, so we want to take a little bit moderate final resolution data, so which we could able to get it from the Landsat data, because Landsat data we could able to generate the DM land surface temperature of 30 meter resolution, though it is a resolution of 90 and this one. And the more thing is that it is freely available, so why not use the open source data which can make our terrain inputs and more enriched. So that is the logic behind which we have started the work. And this work we have mostly confined with the summer work, and we used the satellite data from 1991 to 2017 to see that what is the dynamics in this terrain. So when you see the terrain overall, we may not able to find much change. But when you see it in perspective of the whether the surface is covered with the snow, that means snow, I mean to say that the glacier is also included. And if it is snow free visually, so you may find that the temperature of both the region has behaved differently. And for my work, I have taken a Karakoram region of Landsat scene of Pathan row of 148-35. And first I have seen the Siachen basin alone, and after that I have seen the Karakoram basin. So now resting back to my this one, because we know that since there is a lot of water scarcity will be going to happen in the near future, so you want to know the susceptibility of this glaciers, and maybe the ground observation is very limited, so we have to make our space derived observation so accurate so that we could able to get the overall holistic picture of that terrain. Okay, so this is the three objectives which I have defined. I have already discussed. And here I have included what sir has told, that during the summer there is one evident is there. So I try to define that little bit detailed about that one, that how you could able to find out the most. Because it seems it is a terrain which is used by the armed forces, we should tell the vulnerable locations so that they could be able to use it for their operational planning and military strategic purpose. So we get able to see that when I use the data, I have taken the data from June to October. But you can able to see that, and I have to, when I have to go for the land surface temperature measurement, I have to get you the cloud free data. So you could find out the ranges and wherever the gap is there. So I could able to find 43 cloud free data which I could able to use, and for DM I have used the Astro DM of 30 meter resolution. So this is, so first I have studied for the Siachen alone, and then I have taken the whole glacier including the Siachen, that how we both the regions have behaving differently. So this is the DM which is a classified, which is we can able to see that the Siachen is going up to the height of more than 7,500 meter, and for the Karakoram it is slightly little more than 1000 meter more than the Siachen. And this is the methodology. I have the Landsat data which I have downloaded from the Earth Explorers from USGS site, and using the split window and the single window algorithm for L5, L7, L8 data, I calculate the LHT, and after getting the LHT for the last 27 years, I try to find out what is the mean deviation between the LHT value, so that I could able to find out that which is the year which is giving the positive response and which is the year which is giving the negative response. And why LHT? It is not only the air temperature, it gives the surface energy processes which are happening in the near the surface, and it is very much used by the IGPP, International Geophysical and Biological Program. They are very usually tell that this parameter is one of the very influenced parameter, because it is not only the temperature, it tells more about the surface energy process and the hydrology process which is happening near the ground surface. So this is the way I have.
Let's see the results now.
So then we have find out the mean deviation value, and though we know that in the Siachen area, this is the result for the Siachen, though the area have the very less non-snow area, that means visually we could able to find out very non-snow area, but we could see that the temperature in both the region, I have taken two restroom data of 91 and 2017, so we could see that the warmer, the red color is relatively warmer in this region, so we could say that the warming is really happening in this region. And this I have mentioned by the non. So over the first few years, we could able to find out the both the snow area and non-snow area. That means which is free from the snow is giving an increasing trend. However, the trend is different in both this area. And this is here we could able to see that after that what happened. I just try to make that elevation, because since we have the elevation ranges, I have sliced it into 500. Meter difference, and then we could able to find out that at all the elevation range, this is the elevation range for the Siachen area, and this is the elevation in degree Kelvin. So we could say that all the elevation level, this is the mean elevation temperature which I have extracted from the Lancet data. So we could see that there is an increasing trend at all the elevation range. However, we could able to see there is a slightly warming, because as you go up, the temperature should decrease. But you can see the slightly warming over this one in the recent past. So it may be the temperature anomaly which you need to study. And this type of result we have found out for few years. Out of this 27 years, 4-5 years we have found out the same result.
Is this slight?
Pardon, sir?
It is numbers.
Pardon?
Does it make sense? This number you are talking slight, 20 degree temperature rise. Do you expect it realistic?
So this
something
is
wrong with analysis. You see, such a thing should be scrutinized in your organization before you present for the
forum. 20 degree rise, do you think is possible?
Sir, there are some pockets.
Okay, I'll leave it to you, but you should get it scrutinized. These numbers are absolutely not believable by any forum.
Sir, this is the.
No more comments. Go ahead.
You proceed.
And then when you see the minimum temperature, maximum, and this one, we could able to find out, because there are some pockets, because this LST is there where we could able to find out, and that we have confirmed with that DES MODIS data also. So MODIS is also giving that same result. Only the thing that we are not able to use that MODIS.
You should not defy physics. We are talking of 0.7, 0.3, 0.4. You are talking of 20 degree rise.
Sir, 20 degree, this is the reflect emitted range and the reflected range which we are able to get it. That one.
Something is wrong with your number.
And then in the Karakoram we find the slightly relatively warmer in that region, because what happened, we could able to find out whatever the ranges, we could find out overall the Karakoram we were taking, we are finding slightly relatively increase over that region. And similarly we could able to find out here, I want to say that up to the 6500 meter, this one we could able to find out, and this is a satellite derived, this one it may be refined with the ground observation that we have checked. And this is the same warming we are finding about the 4005 meter. This is the same warming pattern we are finding. What is the people are telling the temperature in basin, but we need to work out for the different aspect pattern. And here one thing I just want to answer, in the recent this one, when you are taking the minimum temperature, we could find out in the recent here the minimum temperature has relatively cooler in that region. So it may be leading to that, what is the that sublimation process is happening at the upper level, that we need to have it. But here I have taken the whole region for the analysis. I have not taken any pocket to do the sampling. I have taken the whole region for the analysis. So we could see the temperature trend, what is happening. That means warming is happening over this area. And the glacier, however, the glacier mass doesn't change much, but warming is happening. That means our glaciers are in a vulnerable state. And then I have tried to find out, because since that warming which you have shown that one, I could try to find out the region that is the non-snow area. Which is the non-snow area, it is by giving the alarm which is showing in the different red color. And this is the same LHD with the temperature, surface energy, what surface area which I am telling, that though the area is not increasing, but in the recent year when we have taken the five years average, we could find out both the non-snow and snow area, it is giving in the increasing mode. And then what we try to see, because only elevation doesn't make a difference. We have to see the aspect one. And this is few results we have shown for the aspect one. If you see the different aspect, like we have the eight aspects are there. So you could able to find out this is, I have taken the temperature of 0 degree isotherms. So we could see that there is a fluctuation is there. This is for the total data set which you have done, and right now we are working for that area so that we could tell that which pocket has been the one. This is the main area which is, and this is the tell the variability, that is the standard deviation we have plotted at different elevation level. And then it will only not only the mean, maximum and mean, minimum, maximum value. It may be the median, and if you could take the lower quintile of 25 degree, whatever the data set is there, and higher quintile, we need to work out so that we could able to tell that what is the exact process is telling. This is only one part which we are telling that the temperature is there. This is already sir has shown. And this is the mass movement which is happening for 2010. We try to model and we try to show that what are the vulnerable zones are there. Out of the 88 AOIs which I have taken, I have told that these are the 7 locations which are in red color, which is giving more vulnerable. That when these sites are in this data I have analyzed as per the September 2010 data, and then the vulnerability had been decreased. This is moderate vulnerable region and this is the least vulnerable region. And then we could able to see that whatever observation we are seeing is only one gamut of things we are telling. We need to make it all the data which will be land surface compressive model so that it can include all the parameters and it able to tell. Because only seeing only one pocket, we may not able to tell the what is really happening. But if you take the overall area, then we could able to tell what is the real status of the glacier. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much.